and Michael and Maddie. Today is Tuesday morning, December 5th, 2023. Happy birthday to Saint West, Kim and Kanye's son, turning 8 years old today. It was on this date. In 1955, the black community launched their boycott of the Montgomery, Alabama bus system after Rosa Parks was arrested because she wouldn't give her seat up to a white man. Two unknown Boston actors named Ben Affleck and Matt Damon appeared in their own movie alongside Robin Williams in Good Will Hunting. It came out 26 years ago today.
See, the sad thing about a guy like you is in 50 years, you're going to start doing some thinking on your own, and you're going to come up with the fact that there are two certainties in life. One, don't do that. And two, you dropped 150 grand on an education you could have got for $1.50 in late charges at the public library.
11 years ago, Kesha had the number one song here at Fun 107 with Die Young. And tonight is the night of Krampus, which means our favorite half-goat, half-demon companion comes around to punish all the naughty children. So we hope. Fun 107, Michael and Maddie, what an emotional day yesterday as we kicked off Holiday Wish Week. We're going to meet our second Holiday Wish family of the week coming up in just a few minutes here on Michael and Maddie. Going to be kind of a cooler day than we had yesterday. We're not going to get out of the 40s. We'll be lucky to even hit 40. Sun and clouds and then maybe even some snow showers later on, late tonight into tomorrow. No accumulation is expected, though, so we should be good to go there.
Bring in your taste of Hollywood right here to the South Coast, and we are here for it. We're spilling the tea with Maddie's Entertainment Update on the Michael and Maddie Show.
Sylvester Stallone's inaugural Rocky Day got the coolest reenactment ever, and it came courtesy of a young, loud fan who knows the movie's lines by heart. The legendary actor was in Philly on Sunday to celebrate the first ever holiday dedicated to him and his on-screen character. And not to mention, he was, you know, with his famous statue there in town. Have you ever seen the statue?
Not in person,
it's
no.
Awesome. I hung off the statue.
Did you really?
Swear to God.
Yeah.
You're supposed to do that?
Probably not. I climbed it and just kind of like grabbed his arm and showed my arm too.
The most epic thing I've ever seen that with that statue is when the Patriots are playing the Eagles. And of course, the statue's in Philadelphia. And somebody put a Patriots jersey on the statue.
That's messed up.
Yeah, that's good.
That's so messed up. So there was a really sweet moment. It was an interaction between Sylvester Stallone and a young fan. And the kid just went all out on reciting one of the most epic speeches from the film.
Sunshine and rainbow.
It's amazing.
It's incredible. He's screaming. And it's funny because you can tell Sylvester, like, doesn't remember all the words.
I know. Like, he knew the words better than he did.
He was like, this is crazy.
So funny.
If this boy looks familiar, it's because he's making a thing of this lately. In fact, he recently did something similar with Hulk Hogan recently. So I guess this young man is going around and impressing the heck out of big macho stars from back in the day. And definitely feeling it. And happy Rocky Day.
Wait a minute. This isn't the same kid who got off the school bus and was like, this is it. Like, school is done, baby.
I don't know.
Oh, if that is, that kid is epic.
I don't know. He recently did it with Hulk Hogan. So, I mean, this kid is an inspiration in the making. It's great.
Fun fact, Madeline Levine has never seen Rocky. Shame. Shame on you. You're a fighter. Yeah, you call yourself a fighter?
Bruh, I live the Rocky lifestyle. Okay, I don't need to watch the movie.
She is the Rocky.
God. As people pay more and more for streaming services, the practice of bundling is getting more and more popular, and it could be the future of subscribing. Netflix being bundled with Max for the first time. The ad-supported versions of both streaming services are going to be bundled together by Verizon for just $10 a month.
Ooh, wow.
Making the offer to wireless customers who have certain unlimited plans. That's a savings of $7, or about 40%. And as the practice of bundling in the streaming world becomes more and more commonplace, given all the streaming services out there, The Hollywood Reporter saying the lone wolf, Apple TV Plus, has been talking with Paramount Plus about a team-up, although no details.
If only there was a service that would take a bunch of different channels and put it into one box.
You read my mind. I'm like, so we're going back to cable television. Okay, yeah. Excellent. But it's like, that's so typical of the human race. Like, think about, like, our, just the way we do things, like fashion. And just, like, it all comes right
cyclical.
Back around.
Everything.
Like, we give it a try. We try something new. Let's keep trying something new. And we're back to square one.
Politics is cyclical. All of it is cyclical.
Oh, my God. It's so crazy. Like, we will, I feel like we will see a day where it's, like, a TV guide of, like, there's Apple TV.
No,
there's
an actual
Max,
printed
or
TV
paper,
guide.
Yeah, either one. You know, just in case you run out of Wi-Fi, here's the paper version. Yeah. Oh, really? That's what we're, okay. So we're going to see that day, I think. I'm excited about this bundle, though, because I'm a Verizon.
It's a good
character.
Deal, except I don't like the commercial part. They'd get me if it was the bundle with the commercial-free one.
How do you know it's commercials, though?
You said it.
Did I say it? Yeah. Did that come out of my mouth?
Okay. No, but that'll be the next
step. Ad-supported. Okay, ad-supported versions. Commercials. Got it.
Add an extra $5 for no ads. That's how it goes.
Yeah, and then it's the same price.
Yep.
A famous holiday song just made music chart history. A very happy holidays for Brenda Lee's Rockin' Around the Christmas Tree. It just hit number one for the very first time. It took 65 years to get to the number one spot. That's the longest it has ever taken a song to go from release to number one. A record previously held by none other than Mariah Carey, All I Want for Christmas Is You, which took 25 years to get to the number one spot. I think this is going viral for a couple reasons. Definitely going viral because it's the sound on TikTok that everybody is loving to use, but also because this incredible fact, she was 13 when she recorded this song.
That's right.
Yeah, she's still alive, right?
78
but
years
this
old.
This voice right here is 13.
Rocking around the Christmas tree at
that's
Christmas
wild.
Party
that's funny. She's like a grandmother. Then, like, she's not
your
grandmother then.
You're telling me that that voice is not coming out of a voluptuous 40-year-old woman. Like, you're joking me. Unreal. So crazy. She's 78 now. She's the oldest artist ever with a current Hot 100 number one.
That's hot.
You turn 78 and you get a knock on the door.
Hot take.
Brenda Lee, you are number one. Congratulations.
Hot take. I like this song way more than I like Mariah Carey's All I Want
time.
For Christmas.
I like this song more. Yeah, I do.
This is a solid song.
I got a question for you, though, but because you said Mariah Carey was the last one.
Yep.
What about Kate Bush?
I don't know. I guess
because
in the span of time, though. Maybe
it took 37 years for Kate Bush to hit number
maybe
one.
Maybe this is, they're talking about holiday songs.
Okay, yeah, maybe.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because this says right here. The record was previously held by Mariah Carey. It took her 25 years to get to number one. So maybe they're just referencing holiday music.
Yeah, but that's funny because it makes the Kate Bush thing that happened a couple of years ago look like, it's not that great.
Next year?
Kate, with Rockin' Around the Christmas Tree, what was it, 65 years? Is that what it was?
Yep.
So Kate Bush, just 37 years. It's no big deal.
Yeah, that's true.
It'll be Feliz Navidad next year. Watch.
Oh my gosh, how much money did Kate Bush make from Stranger Things was the first thing that popped up. Any guesses?
I remember she was making like $500,000 a day or something like that at one point. I don't know, $4 million?
$2.3 million between May. $2.3 million between May 27th and June 23rd.
So it was $500,000 a week. That's what it was.
Wow.
That's wild.
Nice.
More entertainment news. Up on the Fun 107 app, we're going to meet our second Holiday Wish Week family coming up in a minute. We've got Olivia tickets all week long. Her sold out show in April at the Garden. And we've got a bunch of tickets to give away next week. Make sure you've got that Fun 107 app on your phone so you are ready to go. But this week, of course, it is Holiday Wish Week. And it is time to meet our second family of the week. They are the Amaral family, and they are from New Bedford. And you've got Kyle Amaral, who is the dad, and Joanne is the mom. And then Christopher goes to New Bedford High School, and we've got
Amari,
thank you, who goes to Keith. And so everything was going fine in their family. You know, finances tight, just like everybody else. But then the pandemic hit, and Kyle did not get, you know, any kind of a checkup. Obviously, nobody was going to the doctors back then. And so it had been a minute since Kyle had been to get a physical checkup. Goes in, gets his checkup, does the blood work, goes home. Doctor calls and says, you got to get back in here because these kidney levels are crazy. And so he went in, and that's when he found out that he had some serious kidney disease. And we pick up our interview with the Amaral family. Here is Kyle and his wife, Joanne.
Stage 5 kidney failure. I don't know why. The last test I had, I was at 9. I'm at 9%. Last time I checked, which was like 3 or 4 months ago. So I'm about due for another blood test that I don't know what I'd be at.
Are you working? There's no way, right?
No. Yeah, no.
I mean, so what did you do before?
Mostly sales. I mean, I've done everything but sales. I worked at Town Fair Tire. I was a manager at the Fairhaven location years ago. I worked at Best Buy for years. K Jewelers, JCPenney. I've done a little bit of the construction, Titleist. I don't stay places very long. I move around a little bit. I tell my friends, you know, if I don't like the way something's going, I quit. You know, my jobs, I quit a lot of things. This I can't quit. You know, this is the one thing I won't give up on this.
So how is this, you know, I mean, other than the obvious, how has this changed your day-to-day life?
Oh, it's brutal. These days, I can't even wash myself. I got a shower chair because I can't hold myself up. Just, you know, it's not aches and pains. It's like chronic pain. AARP. I think yesterday.
Well, it's funny you bring that up because to me, you're alarmingly young looking. And to be dealing with this, I don't want to be rude, but how old are you?
I'm 41. I was diagnosed. I was 38, going on 39. Both my parents didn't live past their 40s. I mean, before COVID, I was a healthy 208-pound gym guy, you know. There's days where I wake up and it's like you feel like a regular person, you know. Because it's like I got 2 kids, they're in school. You know, my wife's working 2 jobs. Stuff's got to get done around the house. Like, you know, it wasn't like I just slept today. I was doing laundry and just stuff around the house.
Where do the kids go to school?
We have a freshman at New Bedford High, and then our son goes to, well, that's my stepson, her son, and our son's 8th grader at Keith.
My oldest son's on the autism spectrum, so I mean, I was already on that journey, so obviously this put a huge wrench in everything.
And so, and now you're the only one who's physically able to get out there and work. That must be a lot of pressure on you.
I'm on my second double. I do 3 doubles a week. I work overnights, and then I work a day shift. I work at Chamberlain International on my overnight, and then I do in the Masket group. I do one-to-ones with adults with disabilities. It's basically trying to make sure that there's food on the table. You know, we don't know how many more Christmases we'll have. So, you know.
And every Christmas should be special.
But with this coming up, you know, it's on the top of our head right now with this Christmas because...
Unfortunately, if I had to wait for someone to pass, I believe the waiting list is like 6 to 8 years. Do I have that long? Who knows? You know, I could... You know, obviously, they want me to push for a living donor. I do have a Facebook page, I believe. Yeah. That I do know social media. I've never done it. My wife does it for me. What's it called?
Kidney for Kyle Amaral.
Kidney for Kyle Amaral. Just the awareness of, hey, you know, this guy's got a family, and you know, he's trying to live a little longer than his parents did. You know, trying to make it past the 40s.
41 years old, and his kidney's at 9%.
He shared how his both of his parents didn't make it past the mid-40s. So you could, you know, obviously hear the nervousness and the anxiety that this family must be experiencing. And for Joanne to have to step up and be the breadwinner for the home and also be the mom and be the wife, and it's a lot. And I think, you know, they could certainly use some help this holiday season.
And you heard her saying, and her voice cracked when she was saying it, about how she really wants this Christmas to be special. And Kyle said, you know, every Christmas should be special, but she's concerned, you know, she's very concerned. And so she wants to make this special and a Christmas to remember. And if we could help her out, you know, obviously she's working the double. She's working as much as she can, and they're barely getting by here. So Christmas is just not going to happen unless we help make it happen. So let's make it happen.
If you'd like to learn more about the family, you can read about them on the Fun 107 app. There's plenty of info on how you can help, but simple, just text the word wishes 23 to 26989 or give us a call 508-994-1071.
And I know that Christopher, he runs track, could really use some track shoes, sweatpants. We're going to get to that coming up in a few minutes here, but he, for anybody who you know, is an athlete, maybe went to New Bedford High School, here's a kid that's looking to run track but needs some help there. So we'll get to that coming up in a few minutes. It's Holiday Wish Week. Call us up. Let's help this family out. 508-994-107. Fun 107, Michael and Maddie, Holiday Wish Week. And we just introduced you to the Amaral family. You've got 41-year-old Kyle Amaral, who is suffering from stage 5 kidney failure. He's down to just 9% kidney function. And, you know, when we met him, I thought he looked great. You know, he looked pretty strong that day, but he said he hadn't slept for a while.
He said he was basically on overdrive, like just getting through it.
Yeah. But he can't work anymore, obviously. So his wife, Joanne, has been pulling doubles and, you know, working as much as she can. And it's, you know, it's financially, it's a struggle for the Amaral family. So we're going to try to help them out because Joanne is very concerned about this Christmas, wants to make this Christmas special, especially with Kyle, you know, in the condition he's in right now. So we're looking to help out their children. They've got Christopher, who's a freshman at New Bedford High School, and they've got Amari, who is an eighth grader at Keith Middle School. And you know what? Well, here's Joanne talking about, I guess Christopher is running track, winter track, and well, here's what she has to say about that.
Well, yeah, because I'll be honest, like right now, he doesn't like practice. He's wearing like ripped old sweatpants. I can't afford to buy him new stuff because it's winter, so he has plenty of shorts, but he has no jogging pants, no sweatshirts. I was kind of thinking about that, and I was the other day, and I was like, oh man. I was like, this poor kid's going to go to school with, they're probably going to start making fun of him because he'll have the same stuff because, you know, he just decided recently he wanted to join the track team, so.
Yeah, this wasn't planned either.
What do you guys like to do as a family?
But yeah, just, I mean, we're simple, you know, dinner, movie, window shop, because we don't got money, you know, walk through the Providence Lace Mall and, you know, build the wish list in your head. They don't really play with toys. I mean, again, they're kind of grown out of the toy phase. They're four. Well, one's going to be 14.
Christmas Eve. It's his birthday. Yeah, I already had that conversation where we told him we can't afford a party. Sorry. Yeah.
When he was younger, he used to get doubled up. Now it's more like.
How old will he be?
14.
Okay. 14.
I mean, where would he want a birthday party?
I think the last one we had for him was at Play.
Yeah, it was at Play.
It was a couple years ago. I think it was 2 years ago. Yeah.
He loves that place. Yeah. That's
Play Arcade.
It would definitely mean the world to us because at the end of the day, knowing that your community is behind what you're going through and that you know, it's the emotional support, you know, is how you feel when your community reaches out and you feel, we're both born and raised in New Bedford, so, you know, that would be huge for us to know that our city's behind us.
Like to think I'm a fixture in the city. I mean, for years I've been going out, part of the nightlife when I was younger, and hopefully something that, you know, happens where I can get that second chance that I hopefully that I get.
And that Facebook page one more time?
Kenny for Kyle Amaral.
And you can actually find that Facebook page on the Fun 107 app this morning. So, I mean, they don't ask for much. And you can just hear how humble and kind these people are. They don't want to ask for much, but we're going to help them. And their son, Christopher, loves the WWE, loves the wrestling world, is very excited about his new adventures in track. Amari loves anime, and they all just love spending time together, going out together, having dinner, going to the movies, just doing family things together.
And they just don't have the money for that right now.
They just don't have the funds for it. So if you can help, any amount helps, whether it's $1 or $100, whatever you can afford, you can text the word WISHES23, so that's WISHES23, to 26989. Or give us a call, 508-994-1071.
Two things I'm thinking. So, Amari, his birthday's coming up on Christmas Eve, like they had mentioned. They're not going to have a birthday party for this kid.
Mm-hmm.
And he really loves Play Arcade. Maybe somebody could donate a birthday party to Play Arcade. Number two, Christopher, the freshman at New Bedford High School, running track, and his mom says that he doesn't have a sweatshirt, doesn't have sweatpants, doesn't have running shoes.
Maybe somebody could get him some shoes.
Is there a New Bedford High School alum out there? Maybe you ran track. You know what kind of track shoes this kid wants. You know maybe a New Bedford High sweatshirt this kid could have. Can anybody help this kid? 508-994-1071. Or you can text the word WISHES23 to the number 26989 and make a donation in any amount. It is 6:55. 90-second news update. Phil.
A research project in the south end of New Bedford caused a stir Monday, with some people wondering why a turbine was being built there without any public notice. It turns out it's just a prototype of an offshore turbine, and it's there to run some tests. T-Omega Wind tells us that a neighborhood meeting on the project is set at the wastewater treatment plant on Thursday at 6 p.m. The research project is being supported by the Massachusetts Clean Energy Center, with grants totaling just about $800,000. Charges for a New Bedford juvenile who was found at Seaport Inn across the bridge, allegedly with a concealed firearm. Police say the 17-year-old initially fled from them after they spotted him with a weapon on surveillance footage, and that they also found that same gun loaded in a room at the inn. The teen is charged with misleading police, unlawful possession, and resisting arrest. He was placed into the custody of the Department of Youth Services. A former employee at Harvard University's Kennedy School is filing a whistleblower complaint. Joan Donovan claims she was fired when she started analyzing documents alleging Facebook was causing significant harm. Her research was happening as Harvard finalized a $500 million donation from Facebook founder Mark Zuckerberg. An NPR station in Boston reports a university spokesman called Donovan's complaint baseless and full of inaccuracies. The U.S. Food and Drug Administration is expected to grant approval this week to a gene editing therapy developed in part locally. Boston-based Vertex Pharmaceuticals and Swiss partner CRISPR Therapeutics developed the drug. It treats severe cases of sickle cell disease. The drug was recently approved by British regulators. Swift and Barbie are on the shortlist for Time Magazine's 2023 Person of the Year. The publication unveiled the final list of candidates for the honor yesterday. Others on the list include Hollywood strikers, Chinese President Xi Jinping, OpenAI CEO Sam Altman, and prosecutors of former President Trump. Rounding out the list are Russian President Vladimir Putin, King Charles III, and Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell. The Time Person of the Year will be revealed on Wednesday. In sports, the Boston Celtics lost to the Indiana Pacers Monday night in the quarterfinal of the NBA in-season tournament. They host the Cleveland Cavaliers on December 12th. Thursday night, it's the Bruins and the Buffalo Sabres, and the New England Patriots head to Pittsburgh to play the Steelers. We'll check traffic and weather next. From the Charred Oak Tavern Newsroom, I'm Phil Devitt for Fun 107.
And Maddie, that is the Kid Leroy, and Too Much. It is Holiday Wish Week here, and we introduced you this morning to the Amaral family. Kyle Amaral, 41 years old. He's the dad, married to Joanne, and they've got Their two kids, 15-year-old Christopher, who is a freshman at New Bedford High School, runs track there, and 13-year-old Amari, who's eighth grader at Keith Middle School. He's going to be turning 14 in a couple of weeks, and he's going to be having a nice play arcade birthday party, thanks to somebody very kind and an anonymous donor.
And I did check in to play arcade, and they're going to give him the VIP experience.
That's
anything
great.
They want, unlimited coins. That is every kid's dream.
That's great.
It really is. That's great. That's going to be a good time. So if you have not heard yet about Kyle Amaral, really nice guy, big personality. Found out after like everybody got past the pandemic, he went back to the doctor for the first time. It'd been a few years.
Routine checkup.
Yep.
Walks in thinking it's a routine. Walks out with a terrible phone call from his doctor saying, "Hey man, the blood work doesn't look good." He discovered at the time that his kidneys were working at 18%. Nowadays, they're working at 9%.
So here's Kyle talking a little bit about his diagnosis of the stage 5 kidney failure.
Stage 5 kidney failure. I don't know why. The last test I had, I was at 9. I'm at 9%. Last time I checked, which was like 3 or 4 months ago. So I'm about due for another blood test. That I don't know what I'd be at.
Are you working? There's no way, right?
No.
I mean, so what did you do before?
I've done everything but sales. I worked Town Fair Tire. I was a manager at the Fairhaven location years ago. I worked at Best Buy for years, K Jewelers, JCPenney. I've done a little bit of the construction, Titleist. I don't stay places very long. I move around a little bit. I tell my friends, if I don't like the way something's going, I quit. You know, my jobs, I quit a lot of things. This I can't quit. You know, this is the one thing I won't give up on this.
So how is this, other than the obvious, how has this changed your day-to-day life?
Oh, it's brutal. There's days I can't even wash myself. I got a shower chair because I can't hold myself up. It's not aches and pains. It's like chronic pain. AARP. I think yesterday.
Well, it's funny you bring that up because to me, you're alarmingly young looking to be dealing with this. I don't want to be rude, but how old are you?
I'm 41. I was diagnosed. I was 38, going on 39. Both my parents didn't live past their 40s. I mean, before COVID, I was a healthy 208-pound gym guy, you know? There's days where I wake up, and it's like you feel like a regular person, you know? Because it's like I got two kids, they're in school. My wife's working two jobs. Stuff's got to get done around the house. Like, it wasn't like I just slept today. I was doing laundry and just stuff around the house.
Where do the kids go to school?
We have a freshman at New Bedford High, and then our son goes to, well, that's my stepson, her son, and our son's eighth grader at Keith.
My oldest son's on the autism spectrum. So, I mean, I was already on that journey. So obviously this put a huge wrench in everything.
And now you're the only one who's physically able to get out there and work. That must be a lot of pressure on you.
I'm on my second double. I do 3 doubles a week. I work overnights and then I work a day shift. I work at Chamberlain International on my overnight, and then I do the Masket group. I do one-to-ones with adults with disabilities. It's basically trying to make sure that there's food on the table. You know, we don't know how many more Christmases we'll have. So,
Every Christmas should be special.
With this coming up, it's coming, and it's on the top of our head right now with this Christmas because...
Unfortunately, if I had to wait for someone to pass, I believe the waiting list is like 6 to 8 years. Do I have that long? Who knows? I could, obviously they want me to push for a living donor. I do have a Facebook page. I believe that I do know social media. I've never done it. My wife does it for me. What's it called?
Kidney for Kyle Amaral.
Kidney for Kyle Amaral. Just the awareness of, hey, this guy's got a family and, he's trying to live a little longer than his parents did, trying to make it past the 40s.
41 years old.
Trying to make it past the 40s.
Wild. So kidney for Kyle Amaral. If, you know, if you know somebody that, or you may be willing to donate a kidney, just getting the word out there. You never know. Just you getting
can,
the word out there.
You can find that Facebook page on fun107.com. So if you find the Amaral family story, you'll be able to find the link to that Facebook page. Let's get the word out.
So clearly Kyle can't work. Said, you know, said it himself. Joanne working doubles, and they're scraping by, guys. You know, without Holiday Wish Week here, there really would not be a Christmas for these kids. And, you know, there's pretty much day to day. And like Joanne said, you can hear her voice cracking that this could, you know, they don't know about how many Christmases they have left with this family of four. So can we help them out? Our number is 508-994-1071. You can also text the word wishes23 to the number 26989, and you can make a donation in any amount at all. Good morning. You're on Holiday Wish Week.
Hi, this is Juliana, and I'm calling from Juilliard Photography.
Oh, wait, great.
Is this the same photographer from last night at Alianza?
I am, yes.
I saw those pictures. They were pretty good.
Thank you. That was fun. That was a fun event last night.
Yeah. Yeah. So what's going on?
So I was listening to the story, and I would love to donate a session. I have a little glass house that I do Christmas sessions, and I would love to donate a session to this family. I know how photos are so important. So I would love to donate a session and a gift card to maybe Dick's or somewhere else if they want it from somewhere else.
That's amazing. Oh, my God. I'm getting emotional thinking about it because, like, oh, God. Like, just being able to get those family photos done,
yeah,
and to
important.
Have those memories.
It's oof. Important.
Yes, those are so important, you know. So when I was listening to the story, I was like, you know what? I need to call. I need to donate a session for them. I'm sure that, you know, they would love to have, you know, these memories, you know.
That is great, Juliana. Thank you so much. We're going to put you on hold and connect you over to the United Way.
Thank you so much, guys.
We'll grab this one here. Fun 107, good morning. You're on Holiday Wish Week.
Good morning.
Hi, who's this?
Elizabeth Pollard. I'm calling from Andrew's Fruit and Produce.
Oh, hi, Elizabeth. How are you doing this morning?
Good. How are you?
Well, we're doing okay. We're trying to make a difference today.
Making some progress here, though.
Yes. Because, you know, we feel sorry, and it's sad to deal with this, you know, for a family to have to go through this for the holidays and just dealing with the sickness. We want to donate $500 to
wow.
the family.
Wow, that's incredible.
Thank you.
That's going to be huge for them.
Aw, we love to help.
That is great. Thank you so much, Elizabeth. And do me a favor, please please thank Jeff over there at Andrew's Fruit and Produce. Jeff is the owner, and he's pulling the strings back there, but he's too shy to call in. So thank you very much, and thanks for calling in, Elizabeth. We appreciate that. We're going to put you down for $500, and we're going to connect you over to the United Way of Greater New Bedford. They're going to process it for you.
Thank you.
Our number is 508-994-1071. Call us up, make a pledge, or you can make a donation by texting the word wishes23 to the number 26989. Wishes23 to the number 26989. A few more of those things that the family's looking for, Maddie.
So Amari loves anime, and Christopher loves the WWE. They both love playing video games. Thanks to their very generous aunt, they have a couple of consoles. They got a PS4, PS5, Xbox, but they could use some new games. And as far as Kyle and Joanne go, Kyle loves shoes. He's a big sneaker guy. Joanne just wants to have her family together.
Truly.
And she just wants to have a really special holiday. And they just want to be together.
They did say that they go to the movies.
They love just being together.
Like
going
Marvel
to movies, going to do activities. Yeah, they're a Marvel family, she said. So maybe some movie tickets would be a nice gesture. But again, any amount helps. We're talking $1, okay? And we're making it very simple for you. You can text wishes23 to 26989. Any amount will help the Amaral family this morning.
Holiday Wish Week, Fun 107. Kyle Amaral, still young, just 41 years old, says his goal is to make it out of his 40s, unlike his parents. But Kyle has been diagnosed with stage 5 kidney failure, and we are helping the Amarals this morning the best we can. And you guys are really stepping up.
Seriously.
Incredible donations. We've got some more that just came in.
Justine from Lakeville chiming in, texting wishes 23. to 26989, donating $25.
Thank you so much, Justine.
Kyle from Fall River doing the same thing, donating $100.
Hey, Kyle, that's great.
That's what I'm talking about.
Really appreciate it. Nicole gave 10. Then that sparked, we had PrimaCare call in $500, and then Portis de Sedan calling in another $500. All this stuff adds up. This is for a family. Remember, Kyle can't work.
Mm-mm.
He cannot work anymore. 41 years old, can't work. And his wife working doubles and trying to make it happen. And, you know, that's they're falling behind. They don't like to talk about it, but they're falling behind on those bills. So we asked them, you know, what would be their ideal date night? Because these are people who just can't just go out. What would be your ideal date night if you could have one?
Dinner, movie, window shop, shop. Because we don't got money. You know, walk through the Providence Place Mall and, you know, tilt the wish list in your head.
Well, maybe we can make that wish list a reality.
He, you know what? He likes sneakers.
He loves sneakers, and they clearly love going out to eat, so.
Yeah, they like going out. He used to be a big into the nightlife, like before, like way back in the day. He said that, you know, he used to go out all the time in the New Bedford night scene. Mm-hmm. And
he was one of those guys, everybody knew him.
Yeah.
You know, no matter where he went downtown, always had his backwards red cap on. And you could see him coming from a mile away. He honestly was the guy that would buy a round for an entire bar if he could.
Sure.
That's the kind of character he was.
Yeah. So if you can help him out, our number is 508-994-1071. They've got two kids, a 15-year-old freshman at New Bedford High School, and then Amari, who turns 14 on Christmas Eve, and he goes to Keith. You can also text the word wishes 23 to the number 26989 to make a donation in any amount. Good morning. You're on Holiday Wish Week.
Good morning, Michael Rock.
Hi, who's this?
Hi, this is Jay Pacheco.
Hey, Jay, what's going on?
Hi, Maddie. Hi, Gazelle, you there?
Hey, Jay, how are you? Good morning.
What's up, buddy? I was listening to the show this morning, and I listened and heard about the family, and I heard the guy was a sneakerhead.
Yeah.
So I called in right away because myself being a sneakerhead, and I think myself and my friend Cameron Langlois, the owner of 508 Sneaker Store, can help this gentleman out.
Oh, that's wonderful.
With a pair of Jordan 11s.
Oh, wow. All right.
So Michael Jordan releases a Jordan 11 every December for like a Christmas release. And this year it's a Jordan 11 gratitude. Very nice sneaker.
He's the kind of dad that's been giving back to his family and trying to just be there for his family. And I'm sure he's not really getting himself things. So I think this is going to be an awesome gift.
And I think that's a perfect sneaker name, gratitude.
Exactly.
What a nice match.
It is actually, yeah, nice.
Well, Jay, thanks for calling and thanks for this incredibly generous gift.
Thank you so much.
And that's from the 508 Sneaker Store in Fairhaven, right?
Yes, Cameron Langlois and myself, Jay Pacheco.
Jay Pacheco, thanks for calling.
No problem.
Very meaningful gift right there. And if you would like to make a donation and help this family, look, get their some of their bills paid so that they can just enjoy Christmas without that looming worry over their heads. Our number is 508-994-1071. Holiday Wish Week on Fun 107. And Kyle Amaral, 41 years old, diagnosed with stage 5 kidney failure. He's operating at 9% kidney function right now. He and his wife, Joanne, trying to somehow make Christmas happen, even though Kyle hasn't been able to work in years. Joanne working like crazy to try to make the bills come together. And each month they seem to fall further and further and further behind because they just don't have the income that they used to have. And it's been forever since they've even been on a date night. They just... You know, the kids are old enough now. Finally, the kids are old enough that they can go out, and now they can't go out.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just tough. But I mean, I don't think that Joanne could possibly work any harder. Here's her talking about what she's doing.
I work at Chamberlain International on my overnight, and then I do the Namaskat group. I do one-to-ones with adults with disabilities. It's basically trying to make sure that there's food on the table. You know, we don't know how many more Christmases we'll have. So, you know.
Every Christmas should be special.
Special, but with this coming up, you know, and we're, it's on the top of our head right now with this Christmas because.
Look, these are New Bedford born and raised people, you know, and they've been a part of the community their entire lives. And they, you know, were, how many times did they say, Maddie, there are probably other people that need this more than us?
They are so
humble. Countless times.
So humble and just feel just, you could tell that there was just like, we have our family, we're okay. Like there was this energy about them where it's like, we have each other and that's good. And we're, you know, other people could use some help, but we're here to help them because they need it. Their bills are suffering. Their savings account is dwindling. You know, the kids want to have a good Christmas. The mom, Joanne, just wants to give that good Christmas, but she needs some help. So we're going to come to her aid and help her. Justine from Lakeville chiming in with $25, texting the word wishes 23. Nicole from Fall River giving $10. Kyle from Fall River giving $100. It's incredible this morning.
All adds up. And if you want to help out the Samaroff family from New Bedford, our number is 508-994-1071. Good morning. You're on Holiday Wish Week.
Morning. How are you?
Hi. Who's this?
This is Mike Rosella. How are you?
Doing good.
What's going on, Mike?
Not much. I heard the story of the Amaral family, and on behalf of my company, Minutemen Post, and also being a former Whaler track runner myself, like Christopher is going to be, I'd like to donate $500 today.
Oh my gosh, that's incredible.
That's great, Mike. So you said you've got a company, Minutemen Post? What's that?
Yep, Minutemen Post. Yep, so we're a post-production company up in Boston, doing advertising, documentaries, the whole gamut of video work.
And you are a Whalers alum.
Yes. So I started way back in 2005 on the Whalers track team, long distance runner, still running. When I heard that he had just joined the team, I knew I had to jump in and help out just because the Whalers myself have given me so much. So I figure I can give back here.
That's incredible. I mean, that is just, that is what this is all about.
Talk a bit about that, Mike. You know, you said that the Whalers team has given you a lot. Is it character building running for a team like the New Bedford Whalers? What life lessons did you get to take away from that?
So it ended up pushing me into running, long distance running. I ran for Coach Gardner, Steve Gardner, and Jeremy Tilton. And they basically taught me how to become the person who I am today. They basically gave me a lot of values that I don't know if I didn't run on the track team I would have today.
Clearly near and dear to your heart. And listen, we appreciate this $500 donation from Minutemen Post. Mike Rosella, thank you for calling in, man. We appreciate it.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate it. Have a great day.
You too. How generous is that?
So nice.
Let's take another call here at 508-994-1071. Good morning. You're on Holiday Wish Week.
Hey, hi. This is John Stone from Knuckleheads Bar and Grill. How are you?
Hey, John. How are you?
Stoney. What's up, buddy?
Yeah. I've never heard. I don't even think I knew your first name. I only know you as Stoney.
Okay. I'm listening to the story, and I'd really like to help this family out. Any way we can get together with them and maybe give them a really good night out?
Absolutely. As a matter of fact, when we were talking to Kyle Amaral and his wife, they mentioned how much, like back before he got sick, how much they loved going to Knuckleheads.
Well, have them come in and we'll give them whatever they like to have to eat and just a good night out. Make them feel like, you know, a real special day for him and his family.
Carte blanche at Knuckleheads. I love it. That is great, Stoney.
Absolutely.
Really appreciate that. That's a really thoughtful thing to do. And we'll let them know. We'll connect that all up and have a nice night down there at Knuckleheads.
That'd be great. Thank you very much. We always like to give back to the community.
Thank you so much. Stoney, I'm going to put you on hold, but we'll set you up with the United Way of Greater New Bedford. What a thoughtful thing to do. Thanks a lot, man.
Okay, that's great. Thank you very much. You guys have a good day.
You too, Stoney. Thank you.
Okay, yeah, bye.
All right, let's keep it coming. Let's keep this momentum going. 508-994-1071. Can you help out this? Listen, it doesn't have to be a $500 donation. It does not. We've got donations for $5 in on the text to give line.
$5, $10, $25, $100. It's all over the place, and we love that. Any amount helps today.
Text wishes 23 to the number 26989 or call us 508-994-1071. And it is called Strangers. It's Holiday Wish Week here, and it's day two. And we introduced you this morning to the Amaral family. Kyle is 41 years old and he is father to two, married to Joanne, and is at 9% kidney function right now. 9%. And really holding out hope that they can get a kidney transplant for Kyle. Dialysis doesn't really work for him right now. It's not really, he's not in line with it right now. So really the kidney transplant is the best bet for him. And there is, if you know anybody, please just spread the word that Kyle needs this kidney. You can find out more about that on the website, Maddie.
There's an official Facebook page that his family started, and you can find it on fun107.com this morning. If you can just find the Amaral story, and you'll find the link within that story.
I mean, that would be the ideal Christmas.
My, could you imagine?
No, I
finding
can't.
Finding a match, like, oh my gosh, it'd be a life-changing moment.
Life-saving moment. Yeah. And so, look, if you can just spread the word on that, that'd be really helpful. Kidney for Kyle, Amaral. But, you know, we spent a lot of time with the family the other day, and, you know, what I really liked about what Kyle and Joanne were talking about their kids, they've got a 15-year-old son and one that's going to turn 14 on Christmas Eve. And they, when they just lit up when they started talking about their kids, because they're like, God, they just have stepped up. Like, if you've ever wondered how your kids would be if you ever became really sick like this, really ill like this, their boys have just stepped up, and they do what needs to be done around the house. And Kyle said, look, you know, like, I'm going to teach you how to replace this part on a car because I don't know if I'm going to be around to teach you this later on.
Yeah.
I mean, those are the brutal facts right now.
Yeah, Joanne really got me when she was talking about Christopher, who is on the spectrum. He's high functioning. And he said, Mommy, the autism, I'm no longer on the spectrum. We have to worry about Dad now. And it's just like, oh, that hit me so hard.
Yeah. So we're trying to help out the Amaral family. This is a New Bedford born and raised family. And here's Kyle talking about what it's like day to day for him with this kidney failure.
Oh, it's brutal. These days I can't even wash myself. I got a shower chair because I can't hold myself up. Just, you know, it's not aches and pains. It's like chronic pain.
My son, my oldest son's on the autism spectrum. So, I mean, I was already on that journey. So obviously this put a huge wrench in everything.
And so, and now you're the only one who's physically able to get out there and work. That must be a lot of pressure on you.
I'm on my second double. I do three doubles a week. I work overnights and then I work a day shift. I work at Chamberlain International on my overnight, and then I do the Masket group. I do one-to-ones with adults with disabilities. It's basically trying to make sure that there's food on the table. You know, we don't know how many more Christmases we'll have. So, you know.
And every Christmas should be special.
But with this coming up, you know, it's on the top of our head right now with this Christmas because...
Unfortunately, if I had to wait for someone to pass, I believe the waiting list is like 6 to 8 years. Do I have that long? Who knows? You know, I could, you know, obviously they want me to push for a living donor. I do have a Facebook page. I believe that I do know social media. I've never done it. My wife does it for me. What's it called?
Kidney for Kyle Amaral.
Kidney for Kyle Amaral. Just the awareness of, hey, you know, this guy's got a family and, you know, he's trying to live a little longer than his parents did, you know, trying to make it past the 40s.
It would definitely mean the world to us because at the end of the day, knowing that your community is behind what you're going through and that you, you know, it's the emotional support, you know, is how you feel when your community reaches out and you feel, we're both born and raised in New Bedford, so... You know, that would be huge for us to know that our city's behind us.
Like to think I'm a fixture in the city. I mean, for years I've been going out, part of the nightlife when I was younger. And hopefully something, you know, happens where I can get that second chance that I get.
And that Facebook page one more time?
Kidney for Kyle Amaral.
Hey, let's help out Kyle Amaral today and his wife Joanne and his boys Christopher and Amari. Christopher running track for the New Bedford High School team. Amari going to Keith. And if you can help them out, help them maybe pay off some of those bills that are mounting as Kyle can't work anymore and Joanne's working doubles. Our number is 508-994-1071, or you can text the word wishes 23 to the number 26989. Good morning. You're on Holiday Wish Week.
Good morning. How are you?
Hi. How are you?
Good. So I'm actually calling over from Colony Drywall over in Westport, Mass. We do commercial drywall and framing. And we've been listening to the stories that you guys have for the holiday wishes. And so we have... We wanted to donate. We have about $2,500 that we're starting off with that we want to donate and separate between the families.
Wow.
That's awesome.
That's outstanding.
Yeah, but it gets a little bit better. So we have our Christmas party next week, and our employees, all of our men and women that work out on the field, we have about 130 of them. They're actually going to be donating, and we're raising some money. We had all our vendors come together that we use and set up a charity raffle. So once we have that money as well, that'll all go towards them as well.
Holy cow.
Yeah, so we really wanted to help our community and our families this holiday season, and we teamed up with Victoria. We gave her a call and she let us know, you know, about some of the stories, and of course it just really really was heart-wrenching listening to these. So we wanted to help them as much as we could. The owner of our company, Jeff Aruda, he made sure that Any proceeds that we collect over this Christmas party, that it will go all to them. So we just wanted to pledge that, you know, for the week for everybody. So we'll separate that between all the families to help as much as we can.
And what is your name?
Mary Jo Da Silva.
Mary, thank you so much for calling. And just, I mean, this generosity is incredible. This is going to make such a huge difference for all these families. So thank you so much.
Oh, you're welcome. And I hope, you know, I hope they can... They can feel a little bit better this holiday season after everybody getting together to help them out.
And listen, a big shout out to Colony Drywall in Westport. You guys are the best. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Stay right there. We're going to connect you with the United Way.
Okay, thank you.
Wow. How about that, Maddie?
Unreal. I'm speechless.
I know. It's crazy. This is my favorite part of Holiday Wish Week.
It really is.
Love it when these things come around like this. The phones are still ringing, and we would love to get you to be a part of this. Let's keep this momentum going. Our number is 508-994-1071. Let's help out the Amaral family. Dan, Cape Cod, good morning.
Good morning.
How are you doing today?
I'm doing very well.
How can we help?
I definitely like to help the family with the $100 donation, and I would like to make a plea for people to please get tested to become a live donor. I donated my left kidney just over a year ago at 60 years old.
Wow.
It was an amazing experience from start to finish. None of it was bad. It was good knowing what you were doing and who you were helping, and knowing that the pain levels were low. It was a fascinating process. So there's so much good that comes out of it. And I'm truthfully in the best shape of my life. So if people would just get tested, you know, a lot of people can throw their hat in the ring, but only few will make it to that point where they know they can donate. And, but it was a wonderful experience. So any chance I get, plead people to do that.
Dan, did you ever get to meet the person that you donated the kidney to?
He actually is my business coach.
Oh my goodness. Wow.
So he has been a blessing to me and my family for many, many years.
That's incredible.
Wow. That's a great story, Dan. Thank you so much for sharing it with us this morning.
It's my pleasure.
Happy holidays.
Happy holidays to you as well.
We're going to patch you through to the United Way, and we'll get that donation in. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Chills. It's Holiday Wish Week. Fun 107.